Gentlemen, welcome back to the April Fool's podcast. We are here in Indio, California, getting ready for weekend two of Coachella. So it's a little hot, allergies are high.
Trying to find Vanessa Hudgens.
We're trying to track down Vanessa Hudgens so we can both take her out on a double date, but just her.
But just her and yeah, both of us.
Together.
Yeah.
Not but frills.
Also, I don't think I'm ever down to go to Coachella.
Dude, it's so hot. I've been a couple times. It's rough.
Have you?
It's rough.
Did you have to sleep in a fucking tent?
We slept on the
ground
bed of a truck on top of suitcases.
You're lying.
Yeah,
that is terrible. Bro, why the fuck would you want to go there?
No, that was that time that me and Joe Good went.
There's 100% no for me.
I did do a camping one, but it wasn't there. It was like this other guy, like owned this like field or farm or something, and he rented out spaces there to camp. But then they had showers, they had outlets, and they had like fans and stuff in the tent, but it wasn't like anything close to AC. It was miserable. Just go do a hotel.
Yeah, 100%.
Just get a hotel.
Dude, there's no fucking way.
I don't know why.
I saw people like pictures of, and I'm like, these people are in fucking tents.
Yeah, I don't know why people do that. Tenting's hard. Just go to get a hotel. They have shuttles from the hotel, AC.
Yeah,
it's nice.
You have to be in a hotel. I will
or
not.
Or Airbnb.
Go.
Just get a house.
If you have an RV, I'll camp.
Yeah, that's true.
There's AC. There's everything you need in an RV.
I went to Coachella 2010 and I had to camp.
Damn, Mark.
Well, how old were you in 2010? Fucking 16.
I was 20 in 2010.
You were 20?
When you're 19, 20, you don't care about staying in a tent at Coachella. So.
Were you, and global warming, it is getting hotter and hotter every year.
Oh, it's getting way hotter every year. Shout out global warming.
Did you do like DMT or anything, Mark?
Yeah. Did you do any drugs?
Did you do any shroom tea?
No.
No.
What'd you do?
No, but yeah, 20? I didn't know Mark was that much older than us.
He's like 3 years older than you.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of birthdays, this past weekend, Easter.
Shout out the Lord.
Is that the Lord's birthday?
No, I think Christmas is.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But my family sang me happy birthday at Easter because they were all gone.
Oh,
for
that was
birthday.
Like the first time they've seen you.
Yeah. And then I actually brought up we were going to do Twitter hitters this week. What the fuck are you supposed to do when people sing you happy birthday in front of a cake?
It's so. I don't know. I usually just sing
this
with
them.
This
is what I sing it with. Yeah.
I sing it with them.
Or yeah. I'll go like.
It's so awkward.
I don't. Do I look at them or do I look at the cake? It's really weird. And the older I get, the weirder it gets.
And I never want cake. Please don't bring me cakes.
Ooh, but I don't want regular cake. No.
I don't like cake.
This was an ice cream cake. It was pralines and cream. It's pretty fire.
Really? I don't really care for pralines and cream.
I've never had it, but it was
it's
good.
Like a.
I was so
it's like an old person type of thing.
Is it?
Yeah.
What is a praline, a nut?
Yeah. But it's like, I don't know. It's okay.
Did you chill with the fam?
This weekend?
Yeah.
What did I do?
For Easter? No, Easter Sunday or no?
Oh, yeah, Easter Sunday, yeah.
Your mom's?
Yeah, my mom's house. Fred cooked up some chicken fajitas.
Ooh.
So that was fire. Donio and Nick both worked. So it was just me and Marcus chilling. It was cool, though. It was a chill weekend, and then Saturday we had the
Beats and Brunch.
Yeah, Beats and Brunch.
Joe Good was in town.
Joe Good showed. I was a blackout mess. I thought Joe Good was not there.
I was like, am I hallucinating, or is that Joe Good?
Yeah, right, dude, I was trash canned. I had a minimum 100 glasses of mimosas.
Well, I thank God I didn't have one mimosa.
I had 100.
Went to Moscow Mules.
Had 100 glasses. And I still spent a freaking $150.
My debit card's still there.
And they don't open.
They don't open until Friday, probably.
They don't. They're closed. They're just a venue.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Fuck. Oh, fuck.
You might need to get a hold of Adam.
Damn it, because I didn't leave a tip. If you leave, you don't leave a tip if you leave your card.
Yeah, they leave it for you, I think.
I hope they did, 20%, if you're listening.
Yeah.
But that was fun.
That was a blast.
Yeah, I want to do more stuff like that. I bought some merch from Adam. I bought the black one and the tan one.
I did too. I got the black one, the tan one.
They're nice.
And then I even got the satchel.
Ooh. The fanny?
The fanny. No, the satchel.
Is it satchel?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Over the body.
Yeah, it's like a man purse.
Yeah, man purse. Put all your goodies inside of it.
Also, we see, fuck, there was a bunch of people there, bro.
There was a lot of people there. We shout out everybody that showed up. That shit was so much fun.
That was fun.
Dude, it was a blast. I'm trying to think of, I'm not really a house guy.
EDM
guy at all. And it was still fun.
And then the last guy that went on, we left. I left. My buddy Spencer was in town. Shout out, Spence. I left a little early, I think, but it was just getting into some heavy dubstep, which you definitely don't like.
Oh, yeah, I was already gone.
You'll rather have house than just angry dubstep, for
sure. I was gone by that point. There was no, yeah. Called my sister. My sister and my pop showed up. They took my Jeep home, yeah.
Nice.
Shout out.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, I called my sister way earlier in the day, like, hey.
I need help.
I need help. Yeah, I need you to come save me and the Jeep, because I'm not leaving it here. So they came and scooped it. It was chill.
Awesome.
It was fun. But I was asleep by 9:30. Woke up at 4 in the morning with a hangover.
Ooh. Then you like just start restless for a couple hours and go back to bed?
Exactly.
Fuck. Dude, I can't see right now. My allergies are kicking my ass.
It's because it's so windy outside, bro.
I need to go get the fucking shot.
You need something.
I need something. It's awful.
But I was like that a few weeks ago. Like, I'm still pretty bad. But I'm on a daily Zyrtec every morning before I leave.
Allerclear and Zyrtec. I take two a day, and it doesn't help.
I don't think you're supposed to do that.
Every time I think about it, my eyes start watering.
I don't think you're supposed to take two a day.
No?
I don't think
so. Two different ones.
I feel like it counteracts.
You think so?
I don't know.
I think I'm getting immune. I'm building a tolerance.
Ooh, then you might need to switch it up.
I need to switch it up. I might need to go just nothing.
That's crazier.
I snorted some water this morning. I was like, my nose is so itchy. I'm just like waterboarding myself.
That's not. That's not something that's smart at all. Why the fuck would you do that?
It's kind of like a neti pot. Like you pour water in and it goes out the other one. I thought I could just. I don't know.
Speaking of Easter, do you guys do like a? Because we don't do anything like a set Easter like meal. Because you, I saw you ask like Easter ham.
Oh yeah, because we had Easter ham again. We had like ham.
Yeah, is that what you guys do like every year?
We do that. We do ham for Easter and Christmas, I think. Yeah, I don't know why my mom wanted to do this. Didn't do it this time. I like it better than turkey.
Ham is definitely better than turkey.
It should be Thanksgiving ham.
Yeah, but also.
But some people do Christmas turkey.
Yeah, but for Easter, I feel like Easter is just like a barbecue.
Oh.
You know?
Yeah.
It's not like a meal like that?
I don't think any meal is a barbecue for me.
What do you mean?
You had fajitas.
Yeah.
That's not barbecue.
Yeah, that's not barbecue. But the neighbors had
like a potluck.
Neighbors had like burgers and chicken and bratwurst and hot dogs.
That white people have that for everything.
True. That is very true.
That's like the thing.
Yeah.
But I think Easter could be more potluck vibes. Just bring some shit. Everybody bring something or no?
Yeah, I can see that.
I guess it's not like.
I guess if you have like a big, like, do you guys have like your whole family get together? Or was it just a handful of you guys?
Yeah, we just had my grandma. My other grandma's kind of sick. So we went to my mom's grandparents and then it was just us five and then my grandma and grandpa. So it wasn't.
Oh, it wasn't big, a big thing.
Took a nice Easter nap, dude.
You took a big Easter nap. I text you at like 6. And you text me back at like midnight.
Well, that was my second nap.
You were like, I fell asleep for 6 hours.
I came downstairs to get water and my hair's all fucked up. My dad's like, get some sleep. I was like, yeah. He's like, you look crazy.
Dude, your vibrator fixed it?
Oh, fuck. I should have given... damn it. I'm going to make a video of it. I'm going to make a video of me, of the last episode, of me having it fucked up. Because he took a video of it, like, new. So I want to do, like, a little, like, thing. Fuck, I should have had him play it. Because he said something. He was like, what did he say? I sent it to you. He was like, yeah, this is nuts. Like,
what are you doing? What
like,
are you doing?
He's like, don't ever do this again. And I was like, but isn't it kind of fun? Like, you get to, like, salvage, like... Like you get to like fix it. He's like, no, dude, not at all. He's like, it's not fun at all. I hate this. He's like, I'd rather just like have it be grown out from what I did last time.
Yeah.
Not having to fix something.
Not having to fix something. Absolutely. Like, let me see the other side. Yeah.
Way better. Huh?
Way better. But like, I know what he means. Don't fuck with it.
Yeah. Don't fucking
touch. Don't touch your fucking hair. What are you thinking,
I don't know what
bro.
I was thinking, bro.
I'm That's crazy. I would never, like, I've
I don't know. There's no excuse.
I used to keep my hair pretty short, and I would, like, re-line myself up. But it was, like...
You almost had, you had like, a fucking one on top.
I used to rock it. It was, like, a three. Three or four.
Three?
Yeah. Damn. It was short.
That's shorter than my beard. My beard right now is a seven.
No, it's not.
It has a 7 millimeters.
No, maybe it wasn't like a three then. Maybe it was like a four, like a six. It was pretty long. I was able to like comb it over.
Oh, okay.
Like it was still kind of long, but it's not this long. This is fucking crazy sometimes.
That's a little, I like it though. Keep it.
I'm going to keep it.
It's long. Yeah, don't give yourself haircuts.
Yeah, don't give your, go to your local barber.
It could
barber.
Never be as good as somebody doing it.
Yeah, go to your fucking local barber. It's the only place you need to go to.
Happy belated Easter for all those who celebrate.
Happy belated. Do you remember when Snapchat used to have like your best friends? Like way, like right when it first Snapchat like first.
When
came
you
out.
Could see everybody's.
Yeah,
friends.
You could see everybody's like top three or whatever it was.
It used to be like top. I thought it was more. I
no,
it was, like
it was
top
10. Three. No, it was just top three, because I remember. I had like a couple buddies who were like, hey, fucking so and so is gonna see who I'm friends with.
Oh,
and they would like
me.
Snap me like oh a fucking God. Bunch of times.
So toxic.
Like, so toxic.
Send me, it's like keep snapping me back so that
yeah.
you get
so
in the
I
front,
could get yeah, so I could get this top. Person off the fucking list.
Oh my God. I'll say bring it back.
Fuck no. Keep that shit away.
Maybe not for me, I'll do it. I'll say I don't know who fucking XXO fucking whoever the fuck. Sour Patch
I don't know
XXO,
who that is.
69 is
number one.
It's not me, babe. Sorry.
Yeah, and they just yeah, like all right, 120 day fucking. Yeah.
Oh, if it showed like a if
the
it showed you the emojis that show
and the streak?
Us, yeah, like the fire.
Oh yeah.
Well now, I still don't know what they mean now. It's like a yellow heart is like you guys are each other's bestie. But if you have it's just a smiley, it means you're on theirs. Or if it's like a different smiley, it means they're. Somebody that's on yours is on theirs.
Oh.
It's like, or like you're, yeah, that's what it means. Or it means like you're on your one of your best friends. If theirs has a smiley, it means they're like, there's like a triangle thing going on. Like they're connected with
it's
somebody
else.
It's a three-way. Yeah, but not like, I don't know, not like that. But they mean different things. It's sketch.
Really?
I'll say bring it back. I'll vote yes.
You'll vote yes for it?
Yeah.
Is it pimp?
Some of y'all need to be broken up anyway.
Yeah, some of y'all are too toxic for anything.
Some of y'all don't need to be together, and it's my turn to date her, so.
It's next. My turn to date her.
Just kidding.
Dude, four people said no.
Oh, yeah, what was it?
They're either old or young people, but yeah, it used to have, like, the top three. And I was like, okay, if they brought it back, would you keep your Snapchat or delete it?
Oh, that's the question.
68% of you guys would keep it, 32% would delete. The people who would delete probably do sketchy shit.
Damn, that's good.
Yeah.
I'll keep it. Yeah, those are the people that, yeah.
Yeah,
are doing
you're doing
shit.
Sketch. You're the person like, hey, snap me.
Yeah, get this bitch off my
yeah,
tab.
Exactly.
Good. Oh, fuck. I say bring it back.
Bring it back?
Yeah, and that's back when it was simpler, bro.
Days were simpler back then, bro.
What else was simple back then that I was thinking about?
Males not having to do birth control.
Oh, yeah.
Male birth control, bro.
I will not be doing that.
No? I think we talked about this before.
Not on here. We did it at the live show.
Oh, we did it at the live show? I think if someone gave me money, like they want me to be like...
Wait, like a guy like a plan B, or like I have to take it every day?
You take it every day.
No, because all right, here's my fucking stance on this. So, so first of all, female birth control fucks girls up. It makes them hormonal. It fucks up their periods. It fucks up their.
It fucks
their ovaries up. It can make them infertile.
Depression.
It makes them crazy. Yeah. So I will not be taking a daily pill. Second of all, you could just take steroids, and that's you make yourself infertile too. If you take like test or tren or something, you get it like makes you infertile.
Really?
So I'd rather just take steroids if I'm gonna do a pill every day.
True.
But I don't know. I get the equality thing. Like, if the girls have to do it, we do. But it's probably hasn't been tested. It's probably gonna do crazy side effects to us.
Oh yeah.
I don't know.
It's fucked.
Isn't just like a condom just good enough?
Yeah. I don't know.
No.
Yeah, condoms are definitely good. Use your local condoms. You can still go to like the.
I don't know.
I remember in like high school we had.
I don't know. Obviously. Also, I don't know.
In high school, there was like a little place right by our school.
Like a little clinic?
A clinic. And you just walk in and be like, can I get a brown bag special? And they'd give you a brown bag full of condoms.
Oh, it's a dark arts.
Yeah, dude. Shout out my boy Jerry. He used to keep them in his little mini fridge in his room.
Shout out Jerry's parents. And shout out.
That's also why that man has three kids.
I was just going to say, shout out his children.
Yeah, shout them out. I'm here for it. But yeah.
I don't know.
69% of you guys said that they're pimp.
Let's see.
That male birth control is pimp.
Let's see who the fuck it was. 100. I guess it's pimp. I guess like, it makes sense. So then both the guy and the, it's not to make girls, I don't think it's like girls
over now you 100 can stop votes.
Taking it. I think it's like now that we can also take it. As well, right? Or is it...
What a double.
That's what I mean.
Negative, negative, and you're still going to have a fucking kid.
Yeah, see? Then it's going to be like, what are we doing?
Do you think that kid comes out infertile, both of you guys take it and still have a kid?
It's going to be fucked.
It's going to be fucked.
Well...
It's going
to
be fine.
I think the girls want us to take it with as well as them taking girl birth control, right?
I don't think so.
They want us to just do it instead?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't care. And also, I don't know.
I don't know. I do have a question about...
all a bushload of dude senses.
Yeah. Do you remember planking?
Yes, just everywhere.
Everywhere. Why, did you do it? Who started it?
I did not know.
No?
It wasn't that big at Pius, but I remember people doing it.
It was like a huge thing. Do you guys remember what planking is?
But it had to get bigger because of the...
Yeah, totally. I'll look one up real quick.
Was that on Vine?
I think it was a Vine thing.
But just like, they would do it everywhere.
On anything. Just like...
Just right here.
Yeah, just look. Like the... Just on all kinds of shit. Just and why? Take pictures.
Oh my God.
It was the funniest shit, bro. It got like huge for a little bit. Like people were doing it on like crazy shit. So crazy, bro.
Just to be stupid.
Bro. Just to be out insane. Like look at that one.
God.
That one's wild.
His head's in the fucking dirt.
And don't forget T-Bowing.
T-Bowing. They'd go down to like a prayer.
Just.
Yeah, anywhere.
I'm down for that.
I'm down for that. Prayer. Yeah. Set a prayer up real quick. But yeah, dude, planking was huge. Fuck, I should have brought the pictures in. I knew I should have.
Were you doing it?
No, but Nick, Tonio, and then our friend Steven were planking. They went on like a day. They just like went out.
Like a fucking...
A full day. And we're just
doing it everywhere.
Planking on everything, bro.
In high school?
Yeah, they were in high school. They probably just started driving. Like,
damn.
Yeah, like there's T-Bowing.
Bro, that's ridiculous.
So insane.
On the fucking Beatles walkway. Oh, Jesus.
Railroad.
Yeah, that's stupid.
So we asked you guys, was planking pimp or simp?
Oh, I'm voting simp.
Simp? Back then, I thought it was pretty fucking pimp.
It's pretty funny.
So funny.
A couple people died trying to plank on, like, tall buildings and stuff. There's a couple reports of people falling off the side of a building and, like, super high stuff.
No way. People that's fucked.
Killed.
I think that's hilarious.
Planking and just die? No way.
You play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. That's what I was saying.
67% of you guys said it's simp. 33% said pimp. planking, or the lying down game is an activity consisting of lying in face down position, sometimes in an unusual or incongruous location. The palms of the hand are typically touching the sides of the body, and toes are typically touching the ground. Crazy.
Yeah, we need more of that shit, though. It was pretty innocent. It wasn't like...
It was innocent.
Burning down a Dave and Buster's or a abandoned Best Buy or something.
Did you see Dave and Buster's bought Main Event?
No, the other way around, I think. No?
No, I think Dave and Buster's bought Main Event.
Where is Dave and Buster's here? I think I like Main Event better.
Behind the fucking mall. No one goes to it.
I don't think I've been to Dave and Buster's.
Ever?
I don't think so. Oh, by the it's where the Toys R Us used to be, right?
Yeah.
I like Main Event better.
Do you?
Yeah. Or Silverlands.
Or Silverlands.
Oh, I went with some work homies a couple weeks ago after work. And me and this girl, homegirl Gabby, shout out Gabby, we did, we got the high score in Pac-Man. We sat next to each other and got the highest score that anybody's ever gotten at Main Event.
Really?
I'll show you, yeah. It was on the player two players.
Did they?
So, like, our score kept going up, and the highest score was going up as ours went up.
Oh, that makes sense.
Like, we were just kept setting it. We got to level, like, 55.
Really?
Of duos, yeah. So, here's the thing.
How does duos work?
You have two of you on there, on the screen.
Oh, okay.
Getting all the balls. So, it's kind of cool. So, here's the thing.
You cheated.
So it's unlimited swipes. But that means that we're not doing anything that everybody else has been doing. So we won the highest score. Everybody is cheating.
Do you get tickets?
No.
It's just for rep.
Just for reps. But like when you die, you could swipe again, but your highest score like resets. But when you're already on level fucking 45, you can start at zero, and every point you get, it's like every ball and every like guy you kill is a shitload of points. So it's easy to like catch up even at like level 45 when you die and respawn. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So like when you die, you can just swipe and get more lives. But everybody does that. So we still were like on the top. We still have the highest score because everybody is swiping when you die.
I was like, who the fuck is playing Pac-Man?
It's on that big Pac-Man. It's like the big
I've never seen it.
No. It's huge. It's like this. It's like a wall of Pac-Man.
Oh, that's like badass,
yeah,
man.
Okay. It's not just like this. So it's two of us on this thing, and it's like a... And Galaga, too. Those are my favorite, I think. Just
really?
The OGs, yeah.
Just the OGs. Yeah. Dude, my mom will...
So we'll go this weekend and we'll see
I'm
it.
Down. My mom will play... Neeks. She'll play Pac-Man anywhere we go.
Yeah.
Like, she's good at it, too.
My dad was good at Galaga.
It's like a... But Pac-Man, it's like a... There's like a specific, like, route.
To go?
Yeah. You could do it every time and win.
Really?
Yeah, it's like
no, because the things get faster and they learn every level. They learn how to go backwards.
Yeah, but it's
get smarter.
But there is a specific like route.
Oh fuck!
That you like? I don't know.
Oh, like that makes sense because you could like go this way, get the like we called it the ball is the thing that you get, and then they turn ghosty.
Oh yeah.
Then you could kill them. So there probably is a route that you could go that would like time it right. Like you can. Get the ball, they'll go kill them, and then
yeah, like, you by like the time they turn in front regular, of the ball when they like all like pull up on you. And you
yeah,
turn
exactly.
Around.
It was fun. It's way easier with two people because you could just like you'll be like, oh, I'll get the top half, you get the bottom half, and then they split up chasing you. It was fun.
Down.
I'm gonna have to tell her about that.
I'm down.
I'm gonna tell her to watch this because that was a blast. Like, we were there for like 2 hours.
That does like that sounds like a blast.
But yeah, we'll go this weekend.
I'm down.
What else we got?
Okay, life or death.
Fuck.
One sitting.
Whatever's life.
Can you finish 100 chicken nuggets from McDonald's?
Do I get sauce?
Yeah, all the sauce.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, 100%.
So. Well, I remember one time they had ten nuggets at Burger King for $1.
But did you get it? Did you eat 100 of them?
We each got, me and Luis... Luis Medina, we each got 50 of them for $5. And then, yeah, we got food poisoning our shit in our pants. And he didn't get to go to work. He didn't call to work.
50.
So he 50 each. And I think that we were fine. But I like the ones from McDonald's better. One sitting, what's one sitting? Like, if I had a couple, like 2 hours.
No, well, we can't say 2 hours.
No.
What's a good sitting, like an hour?
Well, when I get McDonald's, I eat it in 1 minute. The the hot and spicy is like three bites. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's very quick.
What's it? Well, so what's considered like a sitting then?
But each nugget I can. I guess without standing up.
Like without standing up and going to the bathroom.
Just and no sitting throwing there. Up, no
yeah,
shitting.
Yeah, no throwing up, no shitting.
Fuck.
100.
I could probably do 50. The sauce would slow you down, but I would have to do it with sauce. I'd have to have a shitload of sauce.
No, you 100% need sauce because if you eat your nuggets without sauce, you're a fucking certified serial yes. killer.
My mom loves when you say that. She said it something the other day. She's like, as Benito would say, she's like, that's a serial killer.
That's a serial killer, bro. It is.
No, I could do, I could do sweet and sour, fucking ranch, buffalo, honey
just like
mustard.
10 per sauce?
10 per sauce. But I would have to do, I could do like half one sauce, half the other sauce.
I always do.
Or just do a whole one.
Every time I go, I get barbecue and sweet and sour. And then I dip, mix both.
I think at 50, you'd have to start eating them like full. Like you couldn't.
I don't know. How much do you think you could put down?
I know I can do 50.
You know you could do 50? And I was thinking, I was like, I could probably do 40. And then I would feel
terrible. I could do fucking 50 Hooters wings.
Really?
Yeah.
I can.
I've done it before.
That's crazy.
They have to be naked, though, unbreaded.
Just hot.
Yeah, all you can eat Wednesday, Wing Wednesday. I've done 50.
Really?
Yeah.
Then you could probably do...
Wait. Have I done 50? Yeah. I think to make it worth it, you have to do at least 30. Actually, I don't think it was 50. I know it was at 40.
I could probably...
And I think those are harder to eat than those.
15 wings.
Unbreaded, though?
Naked, yeah.
Naked?
Is
that a crazy... I think I can do at least 50 wings. One sitting, let me digest, let it... I don't know.
Okay, so, but...
Life or death, yes.
McDonald's fucking...
Nuggets. Life or death.
100? You could do 100?
I could do it. If my life depended on it.
I thought for sure you were going to be like, oh yeah, I could do that, no fucking problem. And I was going to be like, all right, let's go fucking do a video for it.
Right now?
Not right now, but this...
You don't have like 100 wings on you right now.
No, I don't.
Okay. I'm down to try that. You'd have to let me throw up after. I'm not letting it reach my ass, dude.
Not letting it reach my ass.
I can't. It'll hurt, bro. I'll have to call in. Oh, dude, I can just picture me in the middle of the night just... Fully naked.
Speaking of your ass, we're redoing the hot chip challenge soon.
Oh yes, we got him in. We got the new hot chip challenges in, and we are doing a full one this time.
Full one each. That's fun.
It's a different one. It's a yellow one. It's not. It's the new ones. It's a different one than we did.
Have you heard of the Sprite challenge?
No.
So you drink a full bottle of Sprite without burping.
No.
Could you do it?
No.
Could you drink it? It doesn't, you don't have to slam the whole thing.
That's why I drink it.
You don't have to slam, like, all in one drink.
You could just do, like...
You could, like, drink it, but you have to drink the whole thing.
A liter.
No.
Oh, yeah, let's try it. Oh, my God, I'm so excited.
Without burping, though.
Fuck.
That's the only thing. You have to finish this without burping.
Or else, do you have a consequence in the bag,
There's
too?
No consequence. Yeah, I don't have a consequence in the bag.
Or else, you have to get fucking smacked.
You have to fucking eat 100 fucking nuggets. No. No, but
you have to eat the fucking, the evil firecracker.
I know, I am a
cricket.
Fucking burp monster.
That's why I drink these.
I burp for everything. Yeah, these will make me
so
burp.
What if we go just...
I don't know, how... Let's see who could get further without burping.
Okay. Fresh?
Fresh.
Fuck. Did you hear that?
I do love me some Sprite, though.
Fucking burp.
Dude, I burp for anything. I could literally swallow air and just burp.
I can burp right now.
So it'll hurt. Yeah, me thinking about not burping is hurting my chest.
Okay, let's try to just get all our burps out right now.
I can't do it. What the? Yeah, I heard that. Yeah. I heard that was coming from your fucking stomach, bro.
Did you hear that? It's because of this shit.
It like bubbled. That was crazy, dude. That was insane.
Okay. Because of this, my stomach already, I already have bubble shit going on in my stomach because of this.
Your stomach is so fucked up, dude.
I need to re-up on my athletic greens.
Okay, we'll see who can go to the, you have to hold your burp in. That's the only thing.
You can't even, like, let it out of your nose?
No.
So just,
no, you can't burp. Okay. If you burp, you lose. Okay. That's how it goes. Let's see how this fucking goes.
I almost had one, I swear to God. Fuck.
Fuck, I couldn't hold that shit in. I can't do it. It hurts to hold in. You're way further than I am. You have tears? Yeah. Fuck, you beat me.
Fuck.
I didn't need you to do it.
Fuck my up. Yeah. I had a Dr. Pepper that I was saving in the fridge.
Damn, bro.
That smell?
That was terrible.
I've had crazy shit to eat today,
bro.
That was
so bad.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Get it out. Oh, my God. I'm crying.
Jesus.
I had a Dr. Pepper the other night, Sunday night after Easter, and I had heartburn all night.
You had heartburn?
It gave me heartburn. I was in bed.
Well, you have heartburn for anything.
I know, but I've been eating like shit like the last like 3 weeks. I have not been doing good at all.
I've been on my shit.
Yesterday, I just went and got fish and chips and beer.
What's up with you and fish and chips?
Yeah, I've been on like a fish and chips thing.
Yeah, I know you have. Because you got it at Stoneface the other day.
Right, it was horrible there. I think I was trying to make up for that. I wanted to go back to where they were good.
Where did you eat them?
Quarter Celtic.
Have really good fucking food.
That and then Two Fools and like O'Neill's are probably the best. Sober Mesa's are pretty good, actually.
Sober Mesa's?
Shout out.
Oh, speaking of drinking stuff. We have our canvas highlight, actually.
Oh, yeah, let's play that.
Let's run that. That one was it was a fun highlight to do. But
Central. We're here to do a drink review on their craft cocktails. We have 10 of them here to try.
All right, we're gonna get into these. We're gonna start with the Z of Rain. It has a lavender vodka in it, so we're gonna try it out. It looks pretty sexy. Let's try it. Let's check it.
Together?
Yeah, might as well. That thing is delicious.
That's like lavender lemonade.
Yeah, it's like definitely a summer drink, bro. Definitely one of those fruity, perfect drinks that you would like. Fire. What's the next one? The Pinup Girl, which is a organic strawberry vodka. Let's get into this bad boy.
Oh, wow. This one's looking a little chunky.
Dude, that one's good.
Dang. I love ginger.
I like ginger too.
I'll just eat ginger.
Because it's like I don't know. It's like a Moscow. Because I like Moscow. Milk, yes. So it's like beer. The ginger beer. That thing's fire, but it's a cocktail.
It's supposed to be good for your tummy.
You and me know that. We're getting to the third one, the Cuban Link. Just look at how sexy this one looks. That one's fire, dude. I love pineapple though. That's pineapples.
Yeah. These are all definitely summer vibes.
It's beach definitely vibes. Yeah, beach vibes.
Alright, I wanna get my tongue on that rim right there.
You're gonna just take it straight out the top?
I don't know.
I think I'm gonna do it straight out the top.
Okay.
The La Neta. La Neta. That thing is really good.
That one's rough for me.
No? That's like a Mexican drink.
I'm not a tequila guy though.
I love
tequila. And it's hot in my throat now. It's spicy.
Well, yeah, it's a sauce.
I did do too big of a lick.
That was a good sauce.
It's spicy.
Why is it spicy? Next one up is the Cortez.
Blue mezcal.
Another tequila.
All is
the Cortez.
It's like a darker tequila. You can taste a smokiness of the mezcal. That's what it is, bro. It's a smoky. I think it's pretty good. You feel it in my nose. That was good. Like a fresh lime. Yeah, that was delicious. Next, the chancla whisper. Fresh lime juice, orange red cinnamon sugar rim. Ooh, I'm a big cinnamon sugar guy. Lick lick on the front. The chancla whisper. Great name, by the way.
Hell of a name.
That shit's fire. You're from the east?
I like Escalona.
Ooh.
That cinnamon sugar is a...
That's really good. So it's kind of like
I don't know what...
It's like a vanilla marg? I don't know. That's good.
I don't like really... I don't care for margaritas either. That shit's really,
really
good. Yeah.
I love margaritas.
And that's really good. This is the Lolo.
What is in it though?
I'm just kidding. It's like low rock and rye. So it's a whiskey?
Yeah, it doesn't taste like whiskey. It tastes like a lemonade.
Yeah.
Like a berry lemonade.
Yeah, but with whiskey. What are they? The whiskey sour or whatever?
Oh yeah, that does kind of taste like a berry whiskey sour.
Like a berry whiskey sour.
Uh-huh.
That thing's really good. Got the Unidos.
This one has gin in it.
That one's good. I'm not a huge gin guy either.
I'm not either.
But that one was
But if you like gin?
Tasty, yeah. Gin and juice.
Right there. It is literally gin and juice.
One of your favorites is next.
Talking about me?
Yes, sir.
I will not be trying this.
El viejo.
I think it's their take on an old fashioned.
It's their take on an old fashioned.
You have Jack Single Barrel, Jack Honey, and bitters. And
that's it. Am I going to be the one who tries this
one? No, I'll try it.
It's just on a cube, too.
It's on a piff rod.
Classic.
It's probably watered
El
down.
El viejo.
Too. Oh, it's not bad. It's watered down from the cube.
Yeah.
Oh, that gives me memories, though. It gives me Halloween memories.
I do like old fashioned. Last but not least, I'm going to save the best one for last. And it's the street beefs with lowrider beef jerky. Just their take on a Bloody Mary with a lowrider beef jerky in there.
Bourbon instead of vodka.
Okay. There's some green chili on the top. You can get that. A little bit of green chili on the top. Bloody Mary with some bourbon, and you can always buy some lowrider beef jerky here as well. So
get you a bag.
Come get you a bag, especially if you enjoy the one in your drink. This is street beefs. I like Bloody Marys.
I love Bloody Marys. Ooh, that is good.
You wake up, a little bit of heat. You know, you struggling on a Sunday morning?
I'm struggling right now.
You come grab yourself some brunch here at Canvas, get yourself a Bloody Mary.
I'll be hungover.
Low rider beef jerky. Send it, baby. That's about it today at Canvas Artistry. We just tried 10 drinks. Catch your boys a little buzz around here, but they were all pretty good. So, what was your favorite today?
I'm gonna go with that pinup girl, that ginger lime.
And I was between that one and the Cuban Link, that pineapple one with the candy pineapples on top. I just like pineapple.
Fire.
I don't know why. But yeah, it was a good review today. Little booze highlight. Appreciate it.
Cheers.
Make sure you guys like, subscribe, comment. Come check out Canvas, First and Central. We appreciate all you guys for all the love and support. We're out of here. That was the Canvas.
It was like Coachella vibe.
It was fun though, huh?
That was fun. We were getting trashed.
10 drinks.
I was almost getting my swerve on going home. You feel me? Just kidding, Mom. Just kidding, Dad. I did have work that night though.
You said you were going to take a nap.
I took a nap.
Dude, I got home and I was like, damn, I need to take a nap. Because I was like, 10 drinks was wild.
Yeah, thank God we weren't. Yeah.
I crashed my drone.
You did?
After.
Where?
Into the building.
I love those drone pan outs though. Yeah. That's sick. Yeah. It's very well done.
I'm getting nice with it, baby.
Getting nice with it. Shout out Canvas for letting us do that. That was awesome.
Yeah. Shout out Canvas. Hopefully we have some more like partnership stuff we could do with them here pretty soon.
Some event stuff.
Yeah. They liked the video and they liked our stuff. So hopefully be pretty cool.
Freaking throw a DJ set there or something.
When is your first DJ set?
I don't know. We'll see. I'll have to throw out a mix.
You do it every fucking night anyways when you go
practicing.
Out. You should, bro.
That'd be cool, huh? That
could be a thing for us.
I know. No, it easily could
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I'm down.
Like, you just play and I'll just sit there and just hype you up. April Fool's fucking pot.
The whole time. I'm down, dude. It's going to happen. It's going to happen this year. What are my other goals for this year? Get a new car. Bench 2 plates.
Bench 2 plates. Bro, I just started benching 2 plates right before I broke my shoulder.
I haven't done it since high school.
Right before I fucking blew my shoulder out on that bull.
And you'll probably well never bench.
I'll probably never be able to bench two plates again in my life.
Santi can't doesn't do bench anymore either.
I can't. He did the same.
He did the same exact thing. Separated his AC joint.
Yeah, dude.
He's like, I can't. I'm not getting under a fucking bar.
I'm not
bar.
Getting under a fucking bar either, bro. My shit's red. Like, it's.
Is it still popping up?
Oh yeah, dude.
Damn.
It's pretty bad still, but I can't even do like a full push up.
So now the only challenges we do are just gonna burn our asses off in our mouths.
Burn our mouths.
Are we gonna do that in here?
Yeah.
Fuck.
We have to do it in here.
We have to. That's our most watched video. Is our
hot chip challenge. The hot chip challenge. It is. That's
crazy. I have to be have ice cream. I have to be way more prepared. And you're not letting me get up out of this.
You can't. You're strapped in.
I'm not letting you up sitting here.
Fuck. You're strapped in.
Nervous.
We're gonna do that, and we have to figure out
a game to play during it.
A game to play, yeah.
So that we can't piss out.
Maybe we'll do the headphone game.
Yeah, where we'll have the one where they'll ask the questions.
Yeah, they could ask us the questions too. That one's a good one.
Sounds good. Fuck.
That shit's gonna suck so bad.
Nervous, dude. It fucked. It made me stomach hurt for like 2 days after.
Same.
It was like.
It was bad.
Bubbling.
I never had heartburn until that day.
Really?
Yeah, I don't have heartburn. I'm a fucking...
What?
I'm the healthiest man alive, bro.
You don't have heartburn?
I never have heartburn.
How's that possible? That's like a superpower.
I'm the healthiest man alive. Oh my God. Yeah, I don't have heartburn.
Your parents?
Yeah, my mom gets it pretty bad.
Your dad doesn't.
I don't know if my dad does. He might, bro. I don't know if anything happens to my dad, to be honest. That man doesn't tell us shit.
He doesn't tell you?
Yeah, he's just like, if something hurts, it just hurts.
Whatever.
He's the only one that knows.
I won't think about it. Yeah, I won't tell anybody.
I'm not going to say anything to anybody.
That's hilarious.
Just the manliest man.
The manliest man. That's like Santi.
Yeah. Just...
I'll just won't think about it. And I'll go away.
Yeah,
I'm not bitching about it. I'm
not gonna bitch about it. Me, I one thing I'm gonna do.
I'm
gonna bitch about
it. I'll fucking complain.
I'm gonna complain.
That's so true.
I don't even care.
I'll make up things that are wrong with me in my own head. I'll convince my body that there's something wrong. I'll convince myself.
What is that called? It's a disease.
It's hypochondriac.
Hypochondriac, yeah.
I will make my body create a tumor in my arm. I think it's like psychosomatically, I'll make my arm create like a little pebble in my arm to think that I have a tumor.
Oh my God.
No, that's a bad example, but like I could like, I don't know. Like when you're anxious, like I'll make myself think that I am having chest pain.
Like your heart's gonna fall out of
yeah.
You're like checking. You're like, I've heard.
Yeah,
that.
I'm like,
I've heard that if it hurts in your armpit, yeah, it's a heart attack.
I can't. Or my arm's going numb. I can't feel my right arm. I'm having a stroke. That's fucked on.
That's scary. Fucked, yeah. Bro.
That's the exact opposite of like, oh, it hurts. I don't care.
Yeah.
It might not hurt, but I'm gonna convince myself that.
Convince myself that I'm not okay. That I'm not doing okay right now.
Yeah, I'd always be like, Mom and Dad, I think I have cancer. I have like a lump under here, but it's like your lymph, you have a lymph node under here, and that's what it is.
Oh, really?
Or it just could be like fat. Like right here. Yeah, you don't have it.
Healthiest man alive, baby.
No, it's right there. But, yeah. Shout out WebMD.
Shout out WebMD.
Never shout out
because
WebMD.
Every time my head hurts, I'll check it out and be like... And it's really the worst possible thing you could do.
Dude, most problems, it could be solved with freaking water, hydrating yourself, and sleep.
Yeah.
Like, you'll get over most things like that.
Okay. I think this might be, like, our last question of the day. All right. What food has the highest ceiling, so when it's the best, it's the fucking best? But the lowest floor, when it's the worst, it's fucking disgusting. Do you understand the question?
I'm trying to think what really like has disappointed me recently. Sushi could kind of be like that.
Sushi could definitely be like that.
because like it's when it's good, it's good. But
when it's bad, it's
like, usually when it's like leftover sushi, I'm like, fuck, this doesn't taste like anything.
I'll never do leftover sushi.
I'll do it just because if I can't finish, I'll be like, oh, I'll eat it tomorrow. And I'll be like, oh, it's sushi though. It's got to be good. And then, yeah, probably that.
Hash browns or French fries. Yeah.
Hash browns
could be very fucking good.
Oh yeah,
like McDonald's fucking little hash browns.
Fuck, that thing is fire.
That thing is the best one ever, bro. That is so good. It's never bad.
It's perfect.
It's always perfect.
That's probably the best hash brown in the world.
Yeah.
That little thing is
that
so
little
good.
Fucking square, dude, is always amazing. No
it's
matter
a little fucking surfboard.
But also their fries. Their fries could be fucking the best fries ever. Mm-hmm. Or you could get the worst ones, bro.
Fries, yeah. Or they're cold.
They're
unsalted,
cold, yeah, soggy.
Cold. Damn. But when they're good.
Yeah. Is there anything else out there that
pizza?
Pizza does that too.
Even you could just have, like bad pizza, like bad like fuck. Let's make bad pizza like bad delivery pizza. What's the best delivery pizza?
Best delivery?
We had pizza delivered to Ron's house. What was that?
Did we?
Did we? Yeah, you sat down and had pizza with us. No. We had it ordered. Yeah, we had like four pizzas. I think it was Papa John's. You don't have any Papa John's pizza?
I have no idea.
I think I like Papa John's better than Domino's.
My brothers both worked at Domino's.
They always have Domino's.
So they always had it at the house. They love it. They love that place. But I like Pizza Hut.
Ooh, Pizza Hut, but they don't deliver.
Yeah, they do.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
Or Pizza 9.
I don't know if I think like, or wait, Pizza 9 or Slice Parlor?
Pizza 9, I think.
They deliver though?
Yeah, they deliver.
Pizza Hut, I think, is the best pizza out of all of those.
I think Pizza Hut's the best.
Hut's
like
fire.
The crust. Yeah. Like you could, I don't eat the crust from Domino's.
No, I don't.
But I'll eat the crust from Pizza Hut.
Pizza Hut is fire. And then they used to have stuffed crust.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Do you remember, did you ever have
Holy
the DiGiorno
fuck.
Stuffed crust?
No, that sounds
not delivery,
good.
It's DiGiorno. But yeah, pizza could also be a fucking, super high
fire or it's not good
or
at all.
It's not fucking good.
Yeah, it's true. What else? I guess burgers. And the pasta. Pasta is usually just pasta. Mac and cheese. You're a big mac and cheese guy.
I love mac and cheese.
It's usually pretty good.
It's hard to fuck mac and cheese up unless it's just like box mac and cheese.
Yeah.
But even in box mac and cheese, you could spice up
you
some box.
You could make it
crazy. Yeah. Fucking add some extra cheese, a little bit of extra milk.
Ooh, extra shredded.
Extra shredded, bro. Get that thing juicy.
What else is other food that like can be really bad if you fuck it up?
I'm trying to think. Salads. You could have a really fucking good salad too.
Yes.
And then you could also have just a terrible one.
Billy's fucked up. I asked for a Caesar salad. And they gave me this fucking regular salad. Like, a Caesar salad is not just a regular salad with Caesar dressing. It's, like, it's different. It's different lettuce. It doesn't have, like, mushrooms and tomatoes and onions on it.
No.
It's just, like, it's romaine lettuce.
And then, like, the cheese?
It's manchego cheese. Manchego.
Yeah.
And, it's different. I was like, oh, I said Caesar salad. She's like, oh, well, did you want them to toss it for you? I was like, no. No. But I wanted a Caesar salad. And she didn't get the hint, but. No.
Still ate it.
But I didn't enjoy that salad. It had like bell peppers on it. I always get side salads. I do love salad.
Yeah.
But so yeah, you can fuck that up.
You could definitely fuck up a salad.
I know when a salad is fire too.
Do you what I see, Olive Garden just had like the all you can eat fucking
Never Ending Possible?
No. The apps. Bread and
soup salad
and breadsticks. They just started the unlimited all you can eat.
It's only like $9 if you want that too. Yeah. We should go there.
Yeah, I'm down.
And it'll be so cheap.
Yeah, it would be
and
super
I don't,
cheap.
I know it's like not the best, but sometimes I like going to like Applebee's.
I fucking
Red
hate,
Lobster.
You know what?
Like Chili's or something.
Chili's. I do not fuck with Chili's.
No, you don't.
I don't like Chili's. I like Applebee's more than I like Chili's.
Why?
Dude, Chili's just never hits.
Really?
It never hits right.
You gotta get the right thing.
I gave it chances.
Really?
I've tried different things. Dang. I gave it. Because my nephews love Chili's, bro. If they get a pick, we're going to fucking Chili's. That's like.
I like it, but I can see why you wouldn't. But you like Applebee's though.
But I like Applebee's.
See, Applebee's hasn't like really.
And I don't know why. I think
my dad fucking hates Applebee's.
Really?
They've one too many times. Chili's too. Oh, this one guy at Chili's.
I almost lost my life in an Applebee's.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I choked on a piece of steak.
Fuck.
When I was like 9 years old, and there was some lady who Heimlicked me.
And you spit it out. All the bad guys.
Yeah, dude.
One time this guy spilled a beer on my dad. The waiter spilled a beer on my dad at Chili's. And my dad goes, "Get the fuck away from me."
Really? Mad? Like, was it an accident?
Like kind of, but it was the whole entire beer all over his body.
Your dad's a very nice guy, too. Like, it has to take a fucking lot to get that man angry.
And I think the guy was fucking him before or something. Or like, he tried to clean up and he was just like, "Get away from me." He's like, "I smell like beer now." He's like, "I'm at dinner." He's like, "Get away from me." And then he's like, and the manager came and comped the entire thing. I don't think he like bitched about it, but yeah, I remember my dad feeling crazy.
I remember being super young and we went to Olive Garden, and okay, the waitress dropped the whole drink tray on my auntie, bro.
Oh,
drenched.
That's crazy.
I don't know if they got mad. I can't remember. They probably did, but I was too young to understand.
Spilling things as a server is like the scary as fuck. Even if it's just like I spilled fucking 8 waters in the back just like last week. Like, I had a tray and then one fell and I tried to catch it and then they all just fell in the back. We had plastic cups, so it was just wet everywhere. But that like made me freak out. Like, I was scared that happened.
Sucks.
But like, if it happens, like if you're just walking and it happens and it doesn't get on anybody, it's still scary, still embarrassing. But if you're fucking at the table and you spill shit on your customers, or just on the people that are going to pay you at the end, that's fucked. I couldn't imagine. So if somebody spilled a beer on me, as mad I would be, I'd be like, it's fine. But
I'm not paying for anything.
Though.
Yeah, I understand. I'm not paying for
this food or the beer.
Yeah,
but yeah,
that's true. Caught my shit.
Yeah, caught my shit, but I'm not pissed.
No, yeah, but I'm not mad. I'm not going to raise a ruckus.
Yeah, we'll get crazy.
Damn.
I know, it's kind of scary.
I would be kind of pissed, but yeah, I almost lost my life in an Applebee's.
Why were you eating steak as a kid at Applebee's?
Dude, I don't know. I was a high-end fucking kid, bro.
Oh, dude. Bubba's, Santi swears by the fucking ribeye there.
You were saying that the other night. I have to go try it.
He said it's the best steak he's ever had. Fucking,
waiter.
Which one? Oh, yeah. Where were we?
We went to Papado's with your dad.
Oh, yeah. The guy's like, "Yeah, dude, I used to work there. It's fire."
It's fire. And I was like,
"We got to try it next time."
We have to go try it.
We have to. He said it's better than Roadhouse, than Longhorn.
But Bubba's also has very good food.
I like Bubba's food for sure. Yeah.
They never miss, it feels like, to me.
No, they don't.
Yeah.
Ice cold beers. It's fun. It's a funny place for sure. My parents love it.
Yeah.
My good mom wings, likes pizza. It.
Even Cheddar's is pretty good.
Cheddar's is good, and it's cheap.
Yeah. Date Spot, Cheddar's.
April Foods, 3.
April Foods, 3. Yeah, we've talked about food the last 10 minutes. The whole time.
Yeah, we did talk about food a lot. Yeah. Well, happy Easter, happy belated Easter.
Yeah, happy belated Easter.
We have the Easter cock here today. Shouts out Travis, one of our producers.
Yeah, shout out our producer Travis with the red cock. Pulled up on our boys.
Red Rocket came out to fire on all cylinders.
Yeah.
And shout out Harry Potter.
Shout out Harry Potter, shout out.
Shout out Anxiety.
Yeah, shout out Sprite, shout out.
Not shout out Sprite.
Not shout out Sprite. Shout out Juju Energy. Fool's 10% off. Make sure you guys go get your Juju Energy. What else we got? I think that's it. That's today's episode.
Like and subscribe.
Make sure you like, subscribe, comment below. Let us know what you think about the canvas.
Tag your friends.
We appreciate all the love and support. Play the music.
Laters.
Laters.